Hi everyone, today I have another tutorial about carousel animation in Figma. To make it easy for you, I have included timestamps below. First thing, we need the image. I'm using Midjourney to generate the image. I use the imaging command. In this project, just type in a prompt like white lion, front face, realistic, natural background. And after a few tries, you will find your image. If you like to use the same image as me, you can get it from the link in the description below. Now we have the image, let's dive in. I'll start by creating a frame. And change the background color to solid black. Next, I will add the content. I will speed up. If you want me to guide this part, please comment below. For the title and subtitle, follow along with me. I'll start by using all the layout for these two elements, then I drag it here. Next, I'll duplicate this frame. You can do that by holding Option and Shift button while dragging it down. Next, I'll create another duplicate. Then, I'll select these three frames and apply all the layout. I also adjust the spacing. Next step, I change the title and subtitle here, labeling them as Tiger and Wolf. Now, let's reduce the opacity of these two frames. Then I'll drag this frame here, align it with the other elements. Next, I'll create a mask, which will make the animation look better. Firstly, I will create a rectangle to cover the main text like this. And then I change its color to white. Next, I will select this shape and the text frame and apply a mask. Next step, I will add images. Firstly, I will align and group these images. Here's a crucial tip. Make sure to align the eyes of these animals in the same place. It is very important to have a smooth animation. To do that, I begin by reducing the opacity of the lion image. You can adjust opacity using the number keys. For 50%, press 5. You can see that lion's eyes are smaller than the tiger's. So, I'll scale them up and align them with the tiger's eyes. It's looking good. Now, I'll increase the opacity to 100% and hide the lion image. Next, I'll reduce the tiger's opacity to 50%. You can see the wolf size are different from the tiger's. I'll scale up the wolf image and adjust its position to match the tiger's. Looks great. With everything aligned, I'll increase the tiger's opacity and show the lion image. Now I will wrap this group to the frame and send it to the back. to cover the border of the image frame. I'll create an ellipse. Change its color to solid black. Select the radiant option and choose the radial style. I'll adjust the radiant opacity, making the outside darker and the inside brighter. Then I will wrap this ellipse down below. I will adjust it a bit. Now I'll duplicate this screen and give them names. Lion, tiger, and wolf. For each screen, I'll change the content and imagery accordingly. In the first screen, I'll make the tiger image smaller. Then I select the tiger and the wolf image and reduce their opacity to 0%. In the next screen, I'll reorganize the text by moving the wolf frame to the top. Then I'll increase the opacity of the tiger frame while decreasing the opacity of the lion frame. For the images on this screen, I'll scale up the lion image and set its opacity to 0%. Similarly, I'll scale down the wolf image and reduce its opacity to 0%. In the last screen, I'll adjust the text by moving the tiger frame to the bottom. Then I'll increase the opacity of the wolf frame to 100% and decrease the opacity of the lion frame to 0%. For the images on the last screen, I'll scale down the lion image and reduce its opacity to 0%. Conversely, I'll scale up the tiger image and also set its opacity to 0%. Next step, I will duplicate these three screens. Then, I'll scale down the images on this screen. Just scale down a little bit. Now, let's create a prototype. Firstly, I will connect these two lion screens. I will set it up like this. I select the after delay and set the time to 0 milliseconds. Next, I will select the linear option and turn time to 6000 milliseconds. It will create a slow zoom effect. Now, I will connect the lion screen with the tiger screen, then select the after delay and turn time to 0 milliseconds. Next, I will change the time to 700 milliseconds and turn the option to custom bezier. I also adjust the graph like this. Alright, now I will do the same with the tiger and wolf. Finally, I connect the wolf with the lion to make a loop animation. Now, Let's play a prototype. Everything is perfect. That's it for today's tutorial. If you found it helpful, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll be creating more content like this. Thank you for watching.